नमस्ते, वेलकम टू संस्कृति. इन द अध्यात्म रामायण सीरीज वी आर इन सर्ग 10 ऑफ अरण्यकांडम. हैविंग रिसीव्ड द लॉर्ड्स ग्रेस, द गंधर्व कबंदा हु वाज अबाउट टू डिपार्ट टोल्ड रामा दैट एट अ डिस्टेंस देर इज एन आश्रम वेर देर इज एन एसेटिक वुमन नेम शबरी हु इज डिवोटेड टू द प्रैक्टिस ऑफ भक्ति. शी वॉज कॉन्स्टेंटली मेडिटेटिंग ऑन द फीट ऑफ रामा. ही रिक्वेस्टेड रामा टू पे हर अ विजिट. She, he said, would be able to give Rama all information about Sita. Saying this, the Gandharva boarded a chariot as splendorous as the sun and attained the realm of Vishnu. Such is the fruit of remembering the holy name of Sri Rama. Then, leaving behind that wild forest infested by fierce lions and tigers, Rama went towards the ashrama of Shabari. Seeing Rama and Lakshmana coming near, Shabari immediately stood up with great delight and ecstasy. With eyes full of tears of joy, she fell at the feet of Rama. Shabari welcomed him and asked about his well-being and offered a suitable seat. She then washed the feet of both Rama and Lakshmana with pure devotion and sprinkled that water on herself. Offering them Arghya, she worshipped them according to established traditions and offered him the choicest nectar-like fruits that she had been collecting especially for Rama. She worshipped his lotus-like feet with sweet-smelling flowers. When the formalities of welcoming a guest were over, Rama and Lakshmana were comfortably seated. Shabari, moved by great upsurge of devotion, spoke with palms joined in salutation. Addressing him as the best among Raghus, Raghu Sreshta, she told that earlier this ashrama was inhabited by her gurus and great sages. For several hundred years, she had stayed there attending upon the sages. They had now abandoned their bodies and attained Brahmaloka. At the time of departing from this world, she was asked to stay back there with her mind fixed. The eternal Paramatma, they said, had taken birth as Rama, son of King Dasharatha, for the purpose of slaying the Rakshasas and protecting the sages. He, they said, shall be coming there soon, and so she was asked to meditate upon him and remain there, concentrating her mind on the Supreme Being. At that time, they said, the Great One was residing on the Chitrakuta mountains. She was to retain her body till he comes there, after which she can have it burnt in the fire of yoga and attain his status. Shabari then addressed Rama thus, O Rama, engaged solely in meditation on you, I have been staying here awaiting your arrival. Today, those words of my gurus have come true. O Rama, even the rishis, my gurus, could not have your darshana. But O boundless, endless and immeasurable one, I am an ignorant woman born in a low caste. I have not the qualification to be the servant of your servants removed 100 times down the hierarchy. What then to speak of my qualification to serve you? How is it that I am able to see you with my eyes, you who are beyond the ken of mind and speech? O Lord of all gods, I do not know how to pray or sing your glories. What am I to do now? Do bestow your grace on me, she said. Rama said to her in reply, the state of being a man or a woman or belonging to a particular class or ashrama or a state of life or bearing any special name is not the qualification for my worship. Devotion is the only qualification. Those who are devoid of dedication and sincerity in my devotion and worship can never see me by any other means such as yajna or dana or tapa or studying of the Vedas or performance of rituals. By bhakti alone, I can be attained. Therefore, O good lady, I shall describe to you in brief the methods and means for the attainment of bhakti. The first and foremost of these is association with holy men. The second is the recital of accounts about me. The third is talking about my virtues and values for which I stand. The fourth method is hearing an exposition of my teachings. The fifth path is to serve one's guru with full devotion and sincerity, seeing me in him without any pretensions, conceit, and falsehood. The sixth path is to observe purity of thought, behavior, and temperament, as well as to have self-control and restraint, observing relevant rules and regulations, and devoted worship of me. The seventh path is devoted repetition and concentration or contemplation on my holy mantra with all the senses. The eighth path is worshipful service to my devotees, seeing my presence in all the beings, and the cultivation of non-attachment for all external objects combined with the practice of self-control and other inner virtues. Contemplation, discussion, and ponderance and endeavor to know my true nature is the ninth path. O gentle lady, this is the ninefold path of worship and devotion. Whoever is endowed with these disciplines, whether it be a woman, a man, a bird, an animal, or any other form of creation, will have the emergence of bhakti characterized by intense love. When such bhakti is generated, the truth about my nature will dawn upon him. Realizing me in that way, one will attain mukti in this very birth. Therefore, it is firmly established that bhakti is the cause of mukti. If a person has succeeded in the first of these disciplines, that is, the association with holy men, then the others will follow one by one, gradually. O Shabari, since you are endowed with bhakti towards me, I have come before you. Now that you have had my darshana, your emancipation and salvation is indeed a certainty. Now, if you know, then do tell me the whereabouts of my lotus-eyed Sita. Who has taken her away? Shabari said, O Rama, the all-knowing, omniscient one, you are aware of everything. Yet, if you wish to maintain the traditional behavior as befitting an ordinary human and ask me about the whereabouts of Sita, then I shall tell you. Sita has been abducted by Ravana and is now in Lanka. Not far away from here is a vast lake called Pampa. Close to it is a great mountain called Rishyamukha. There, the monkey leader Sugriva is staying with his four ministers in terrible dread of his brother Vali. Vali cannot go to that mountain Rishyamukha, being afraid of a curse on him by a sage. Please go there, O Rama, and enter into an alliance with Sugriva. He will be able to achieve everything for you. Now, in your presence, I wish to enter into the fire, burn my body in it, and attain your status, the status of Mahavishnu. So please, wait for a while here. Making this request to Rama, Shabari entered into a well-lit fire, with all shackles of ignorance burnt in a moment, and by the grace of Rama, she attained the most rare stature of emancipation and salvation of the soul, that is, moksha. If Rama, the Lord of the universe, is pleased, what is there difficult to achieve? Shabari, though low-born, attained mukti by Rama's grace. It is then needless to say that a man of high birth, if he be devoted to Rama, will certainly attain mukti. There is no doubt in the statement that devotion to Rama is mukti itself, and worshipping Rama is equivalent to attaining mukti. O men all over the world, abandon all the various types of mantras which are only the product of ajnana, that is ignorance, and with great devotion, adore and serve the feet of Rama, which can fulfill all your needs. O wise men, worship Rama, the blue-complexioned one who ever shines in the heart of Shiva. Let us move on with the chanting now.
Adhyatma Ramayane Aranyakande Dashamah Sargah Shri Mahadeva Uvacha लब्ध्वा वरं स गंधर्वः प्रयास्यन् रामम् अब्रवीत् शबर्यास्ते पुरो भागे आश्रमे रघुनंदन भक्त्या त्वत्पादकमले भक्ति मार्ग विशारदा तां प्रयाहि महाभाग सर्वं ते कथयिष्यति इत्युक्त्वा प्रययौ सोऽपि विमानेनार्कवर्चसा विष्णोः पदं रामनामस्मरणे फलमीदृशं त्यक्त्वा तद्विपिनं घोरं सिंहव्याघ्रादिदूषितं शनैरथाश्रमपदं शबर्या रघुनन्दनः शबरी राममालोक्य लक्ष्मणेन समन्वितम् आयान्तमाराधर्षेण प्रत्युत्थायाचिरेण सा पतित्वा पादयोरग्रे हर्षपूर्णाश्रुलोचना स्वागतेनाभिनन्द्याथ स्वासने सन्न्यवेशयत् रामलक्ष्मणयो सम्यक् पादौ प्रक्षाल्य भक्तितः तज्जलेनाभिषिच्याङ्गम् अथार्घ्यादिभिरादृता सम्पूज्य विधिवद्रामं ससौमित्रिं सपर्यया सङ्गृहीतानि दिव्यानि रामार्थं शबरीमुदा फलान्यमृतकल्पानि ददौ रामाय भक्तितः पादौ सम्पूज्य कुसुमैः सुगन्धैः सानुलेपनैः कृतातिथ्यं रघुश्रेष्ठम् उपविष्टं सहानुजं शबरी भक्तिसम्पन्ना प्राञ्जलिर्वाक्यमब्रवीत् अत्राश्रमे रघुश्रेष्ठ गुरवो मे महर्षयः स्थिता शुश्रूषणं तेषां कुर्वती समुपस्थिता बहुवर्षसहस्राणि गतास्ते ब्रह्मणः पदं गमिष्यन्तो ब्रुवन् मां त्वं वसात्रैव समाहिता रामो दाशरथिर्जातः परमात्मा सनातनः राक्षसानां वधार्थाय ऋषीणां रक्षणाय च आगमिष्यति चैकाग्र्यध्याननिष्ठा स्थिरा भव इदानीं चित्रकूटाद्रावाश्रमे वसति प्रभुः यावदागमनं तस्य तावद्रक्षकळेवरं दृष्ट्वैव राघवं दग्ध्वा देहं यास्यसि तत्पदं तथैवाकरवं राम त्वद्यानैकपरायणा प्रतीक्ष्यागमनं तेऽद्य सफलं गुरुभाषितं तव सन्दर्शनं राम गुरूणामपि मे नहि योषिन्मूढा प्रमेयात्मन् हीनजातिः समुद्भवा तव दासस्य दासानां शतसङ्कोत्तरस्य वा दासीत्वेनाधिकारोऽस्ति कुतः साक्षात्तवैव हि कथं रामाद्य मे दृष्टः त्वं मनोवागगोचरः स्तोतुं न जाने देवेश किं करोमि प्रसीद मे श्रीराम उवाच पुंस्त्वे श्रीत्वे विशेषो वा जातिनामाश्रमादयः न कारणं मद्भजने भक्तिरेव हि कारणं यज्ञदानतपोभिर्वा वेदाध्ययनकर्मभिः नैव द्रष्टुमहं शक्यो मद्भक्तिविमुखैः सदा तस्माद्भामिनि सङ्क्षेपाद्वक्ष्येऽहं भक्तिसाधनं सतां सङ्गतिरेवात्र साधनं प्रथमं स्मृतं द्वितीयं मत्कथालापस्तृतीयं मद्गुणेरणं व्याख्यातृत्वं मद्वचसा चतुर्थं साधनं भवेत् आचार्योपासनं भद्रे मद्बुद्ध्या मायया सदा पञ्चमं पुण्यशीलत्वं यमादिनियमादि च निष्ठामत्पूजने नित्यं षष्ठं साधनमीरितं मम मन्त्रोपासकत्वं सांगं सप्तममुच्यते मद्भक्तेष्वधिका पूजा सर्वभूतेषु मन्मतिः बाह्यार्थेषु विरागित्वं शमादिसहितं तथा अष्टमं नवमं तत्त्वविचारो मम भामिनी एवं नवविधा भक्तिः साधनं यस्य कस्य वा स्त्रियो वा पुरुषस्यापि तिर्यज्ञो निगतस्य वा भक्तिः संजायते प्रेमलक्षण शुभलक्षणे भक्तौ संजातमात्रायां मत्तत्वानुभवस्तदा ममानुभवसिद्धस्य मुक्तिस्तत्रैव जन्मनि स्यात् तस्मात् कारणं भक्तिः मोक्षस्येति सुनिश्चितम् प्रथमं साधनं यस्य भवेत्तस्य क्रमेण तु भवेत् सर्वं ततो भक्तिः मुक्तिरेव सुनिश्चितम् यस्मान्मद्भक्तियुक्तत्वं ततोऽहं त्वमुपस्थितः इतो मद्दर्शनान्मुक्तिस्तव नास्त्यत्र संशयः यदि जानासि मे ब्रूहि सीताकमललोचना कुत्रास्ते केदवानीता प्रिया मे प्रियदर्शना शबर्युवाच देवजानासि सर्वज्ञ सर्वं त्वं विश्वभावन तथापि पृच्छसे यन्मां लोकाननुसृतः प्रभो ततोऽहमभिधास्यामि सीता यत्राधुना स्थिता रावणेन हृता सीता लङ्कायां वर्तते धुना इतः समीपे रामास्ते पम्पा नाम सरोवरं ऋष्यमूकगिरिर्नाम तत्समीपे महानगः चतुर्भिः मन्त्रिभिः सार्धं सुग्रीवो वानराधिपः भीतभीतः सदा यत्र तिष्ठत्यतुलविक्रमः वालिनश्च भयाद्भ्रातुः तदगम्यत्मृषेर्भयात् वालिनस्तत्र गच्छत्वं तेन सख्यं कुरु प्रभो सुग्रीवेण स सर्वं ते कार्यं सम्पादयिष्यति अहमग्निं प्रवेक्ष्यामि तवाग्रे रघुनन्दन मुहूर्तं तिष्ठ राजेन्द्र यावद्दग्ध्वा कलेवरं यास्यामि भगवन् राम तव विष्णोः परं पदम् इति रामं समामन्त्र्य प्रविवेश हुताशनं क्षणान्निर्धूय सकलम् अविद्याकृतबन्धनं रामप्रसादात् शबरी मोक्षं प्रापाति दुर्लभं किं दुर्लभं जगन्नाथे श्रीरामे भक्तवत्सले प्रसन्नेधमजन्मापि शबरी मुक्तिमापसा किं पुनर्ब्राह्मणा मुख्याः पुण्या श्रीरामचिन्तकाः मुक्तिं यान्तीति तद्भक्तिः मुक्तिरेव न संशयः भक्तिर्मुक्तिविधायिनी भगवतः श्रीरामचन्द्रस्य हे लोकाकामदुघाङ्घ्रिपद्मयुगलं सेवध्वमत्युत्सुकाः नानाज्ञानविशेषमन्त्रविततिं त्यक्त्वा सुदूरे भृशं रामं श्यामतनुं स्मरारिहृदये भान्तं भजध्वं बुधाः इति श्रीमध्यात्मरामायणे उमामहेश्वरसंवादे अरण्यकाण्डे दशमः सर्गः। अरण्यकाण्डं समाप्तम्।